This is my 43rd year in full-time pastoring, and for my wife, it's been probably nearly closing in on 40 years. Yeah. I came back from a trip from Zimbabwe, certain that God was speaking to our hearts about helping, not creating another will, not trying to build another big school, but trying to assist and help. We wanted to make accessible a quality education for those who did not have access or the ability to attain it. Well, presently we have three bachelor degree programs. One is a bachelor's degree in Christian leadership. The second one is in pastoral ministries. And the third one is theology and biblical study. If there is a need for financial assistance, there is an application or a scholarship application that is also available. And those things are, of course, reviewed and vetted. And then if we have the opportunity, we go out and we raise the money to pay for those scholarships, because now is the time to be fully equipped.
Hello, my name is Gary Hay. I'm pastor at Hope Church in Springfield, Missouri, founding pastor, and I'm glad to be here today to talk to you about something that's extremely exciting. The World Evangelical Alliance is reporting some amazing information. 50,000 people a day in third and fourth world nations are coming to Christ. What an amazing opportunity. And what an amazing challenge. Coming to Christ must be followed by becoming part of the body of Christ and being equipped to represent such in the communities. That opens up a question. Who's going to train them? The same entity that reports these numbers is also reporting that 95% of pastors in these parts of the world are completely untrained. This opens the door to all kinds of error. In my 40 plus years of traveling and ministering overseas around the world, and particularly in Africa, I've seen some horrific things. I've heard some horrific teachings. I've seen so much abuse in the name of the Lord that it's terrible. But we want to bring these people into a great expression of what the body of Christ is to be. So, it's a crying need for trained pastors. That's a tough opportunity to make available in these far-flung places. I can tell you as a pastor, I've administrated over discussions for many years about mission funding and what we're going to do, groups we're going to send, and so forth and so on. And in all honesty, most of those things don't produce as much as you'd hope. You spend a lot of money for a small return, but this is the best bang for the buck that you'll ever find in missions. To be able to bring together this caliber of leader, this caliber of teaching, and give these men and women overseas what they need to be legitimate. An academically recognized degree from the United States is so sought after and so valuable and so credible in these countries that we can actually put this in the lives of these people that God needs in that place to represent the people and to teach the people and to raise up a functioning body. We have that opportunity. You would expect it to be very, very expensive. But we're able to do that and literally train a pastor, give him an academically respected degree, a bachelor's degree, which in Africa particularly is going to be required in the near future to call a church a legitimate church before the government. We can do that now for $75 a month. We can train, we can equip, and ultimately give an academically respected degree to these pastors.
This is Pastor Geoffrey Ocha. I lead a church here in the eastern rural area of Uganda in a place called Bulangira. And I happen to be a student of Fule Equipped Bible Institute. And I want to thank God so much for that great opportunity to bring Christian education to such rural areas. We have a number of reasons why this is very important. First of all, we have a growing threat from a number of nations, and we have bills in parliament which are coming up, and they are saying that if a leader is not trained, then it's not worth to lead the church. So we have people who are called, but they lack the training. And it's becoming a real threat. Churches are going to be closed down because we are seeing it happening in nations. So when we hear about fully equipped, bringing Christian education to pastors is such a great opportunity. Then the other thing we see here, because I've been a pastor for some time here, I am a leader in the pastoral circles, and this is what happens. Christian education, leadership training in Uganda is very, very costly. Yeah, a leader to pursue a course for 2-3 years, they may need something like $6,000. And a Ugandan pastor in a rural setting like this is not able to raise that money. Leave alone the time to go and spend 3 months away from church, 3 months away from home, it's just not applicable. But this setting is so helpful that it comes to the local area. Somebody is studying from where he is, using maybe his phone or his computer or wherever. So it becomes too convenient for a pastor who's continue pastoring, doing other works, and studying at the same time. So we are so much blessed to have this program, and we pray that the Lord leads us, that we can come together and provide leadership training to the pastors in these lower areas of Uganda. Thank you very much.
Right now, there is legislation in the works that every pastor who does not have a bachelor's degree, his church will be shut down. That's already happened in neighboring Rwanda. 10,000 churches have been closed because of this legislation. These pastors that we're ministering to know that if they don't get their bachelor's degrees, their churches are going to be closed. There are 7 African nations that we've identified that are either already past the legislation or in process. So I was thinking and praying about this as I was coming. Why should we care? Why should we have enough problems in our own country? Sometimes it feels like we have enough problems in our own lives, right? Why should we care about what's happening in Africa to these people? Because it's not here yet. We're okay, right? So far. Here's why, and this is what I believe the Lord gave me. The world stood by and watched Hitler. And the believers, Germany was a Christian nation, and the believers did not want to risk getting involved. They didn't want to be uncomfortable. They didn't want their prosperity to go away. So they stood by while Hitler took over their country. I believe we're held accountable for what we do with what we've been given. And I believe we have a biblical mandate to stand in the gap for our brothers and sisters. Pray for these people, please. It's urgent. It's more urgent than we knew. And I think it's because Pastor Steve is on the ground, and not one of those pastors, without exception, they're all talking about persecution. They all know that, well, our host pastor, he oversees 1,000 churches. He just had one of his buildings seized and turned into a mosque. Now they're after his church. And this is a man that oversees 1,000 churches. I think they want to make an example out of him. His name is Pastor Paul. We need to stand in the gap. So why should we care? Because we can't stand by. This is a for such a time as this moment. And I can't stress that any further. We have been blessed, and it's our time to step up.